If it wasn't politically motivated, what was the motivation? People went in and changed information in an email, and that email became part of the FISA application. The Steele dossier was used even though apparently the IG report says there were CIA warnings in advance that the dossier could not be trusted. If it wasn't political, was the motivation I'm bored and I need something to do? I doubt that.
Joining me now is former FBI Special Agent John Iannarelli. John, thank you so much for being here with me. John, I've interviewed you a couple times in the past few years, and I know that you worked at the FBI for over 21 years. Thank you for your service. What are your general thoughts on the IG FISA report?
Well, I think the IG report is good and bad news for the FBI. First, the good news. It's very specific in that it's not bureau-wide. It's not the entire FBI. It's a couple of agent personnel, Director Comey, McCabe, et cetera, that may have acted inappropriately and done things that should not have been done. It's not the general force of the FBI that's going out there and doing a good job every day. The bad news? They acted inappropriately. There are certainly things that were biased in favor of them conducting an investigation, slanting facts in the manner in which they wanted. That should never happen.
When we hear from Horowitz, the inspector general, that this wasn't politically motivated, are you buying it?
You know, if it wasn't politically motivated, what was the motivation? People went in and changed information in an email, and that email became part of the FISA application. The Steele dossier was used even though apparently the IG report says there were CIA warnings in advance that the dossier could not be trusted. If it wasn't political, was the motivation I'm bored and I need something to do? I doubt that. Deep down inside, I think people acted on the motivations of who they favor, and agents are sworn not to behave in that manner. They're supposed to be impartial.
And when you're talking about a document was changed, you're talking about Carter Page, correct?
Correct. In the email where an FBI attorney, who the FBI portrays as a low-level attorney, this was a national security attorney in charge of reviewing cases for the FBI. Literally, that attorney has the power to shut down investigations or continue to push them forward, and took the opportunity to change information in email. Why would you do that if you weren't politically motivated?
There's some chatter about whether or not Carter Page should sue the FBI or, you know, anyone else who was involved in kind of smearing his name and putting his family through all of everything that he's been through over the past couple years. What do you think?
Well, certainly Carter Page has gone through a lot. As far as persons being smeared, these few people in the FBI have not helped the reputation of the FBI. The good men and women doing the job every day have it harder now because of the reputation that's being created. It's going to take time to overcome. Fortunately, I think that will happen.
Now, there were some discussion today in the hearings about some of the text messages between Lisa Page and Peter Strzok, which were, you know, high up in the FBI. They don't work in the department anymore or the agency. Some of these text messages were told that there was no political bias there, but some of them were pretty astounding, and it was clear that they weren't supporters of President Trump. And I think if you work in the agency, you're obviously allowed to vote and have a political opinion, but obviously, that was reckless to have those conversations between colleagues. And there were some of the text messages that were extremely alarming, like the fact that they needed an insurance policy that, you know, I mean, we've never really been given a full explanation on what that meant. What does that mean to you, an insurance policy, based on the context and everything that we know today?
First of all, I think it's being generous to refer to these email exchanges as reckless. They were stupid. And it's totally against bureau policy to be using your government device for any personal communications, let alone politically biased communications. As far as the insurance policy, that may be just conjecture or hyperbole, because the reality is they're not powerful enough to take down an entire government. But clearly they were pushing investigations in a certain way. Both of them have been relieved of their duties, and it's the FBI is the better for it.
Yeah, and some people would disagree with your assessment on that, but you know, we don't have the full story. It's just based on some of the text messages that we saw that their dislike for Trump was very, very much out there. They thought that Trump supporters were smelly and they could smell them at a Walmart, et cetera. What other things do you think that should be looked at when it comes to the FISA court? There's a lot of calls for even the FISA court to be abolished. And there's the number's been thrown around that some 99% of the warrants that go through are given a green light.
Well, so many warrants are given a green light because you're not going to present your case and submission to the FISA court unless you have enough facts to support it being approved. Many a time when I was looking at cases, I would think we need to gather more evidence before we take the time to present it. So being approved is not a bad thing. The other thing is, if you got rid of the FISA process and the FISA court, then what mechanism are you going to use to address terrorism? You're going to have to come up with another mechanism, and it's probably going to be very similar to the FISA court. So the real issue here is, if there's problems, let's fix the problems. Let's not throw away the whole system.
Yeah.
Clearly, there needs to be some oversight in how people behave. And I think Director Ray has already taken the first step. He has announced bureau-wide cases will not be worked out of FBI headquarters, which is the way it's always been in the past and always should be in the future.
Yeah, it's pretty amazing. And just from the outside, you know, listening to all this information, it's incredible that the Steele dossier played such a big role in this whole investigation into Donald Trump, the candidate, when it was just salacious, it was hearsay, and who the information came from, Christopher Steele, the former British spy.
If it had been true, it would have been incredibly damning information, and there were those that wish it were. That's exactly why we can't have cases run out of headquarters. Street agents who are trained to do these cases, and then these cases would be reviewed by various levels of supervisors, giving people a chance to push back and say, wait a minute, prove this to me first before I sign off. A case worked out of headquarters skips all those checks and balances. That's why it shouldn't be done.
There's a lot of conversation about the difference between spying and illegal surveillance. Is there a difference?
Well, they're both legal if they're done under court orders. I mean, the government spies, as does other governments around the world. The question is, are you doing it appropriately with the proper approvals to keep Americans safe? That is the issue here. And the fact is, you can call it anything you want, but if I'm listening to you and you don't know about it, I'm spying.
What about the conversation about the deep state? So Horowitz has been asked over and over again if the deep state's real, and a lot of question about it. He dances around it. It sounds like, you know, he's not comfortable with the idea of, you know, people thinking that there is some sort of shadow government in America. What are your thoughts on this?
I think regarding the deep state, I think there's a lot of political division in the country. There's obviously people that are in favor of President Trump and people who are not. We've always had these issues. Remember when George W. took office, the prior administration working in the White House had vandalized computers and removed the letter W from the keyboards, where all of that had to been replaced. It was a very minor version of the deep state, but yet it was still vandalism. There's always going to be those people. Whether or not there's a government operating behind the scenes, I think that's a lot of what you're seeing by the Trump administration wishing to clear out all these longtime Washingtonians. It's too hard to keep the secret. The reality is it's more disgruntled people who don't like our president and want to act in a manner that's inappropriate.
I want to read to you a tweet from former FBI Director James Comey. He says that it was all lies, no treason, no spying on the campaign, no tapping Trump wires. It's just all good people trying to protect America. Did you see this tweet?
I did. I think Mr. Comey is a very creative writer. I don't know how he comes to that conclusion. Even the IG has said that no one's vindicated by this report. Certainly, there were things that were done inappropriately, which have been pointed out in the report. That alone says you're not going to be vindicated. You did something wrong. All of this happened under Comey's watch by the very people that Comey placed in their positions. So I think he bears some responsibility here. But in an effort to sell books, he'll continue to say what he says.
What are your thoughts about Comey in general? And is it appropriate for someone like him to keep popping up and giving his political opinions?
Well, it's a free country, and obviously he's entitled to whatever he wishes to say under the First Amendment. Traditionally, FBI directors have remained silent while current directors are in office, and basically their day is done and they move on. Mr. Comey is different. Even previous directors that have been removed from office by presidents have continued to remain silent. Again, he's entitled to his opinion, but not a lot of people within the FBI really care about it.
John, today people are still, they're not really convinced that the DOJ and the FBI weren't weaponized by the Democrats under Obama's watch against a political opponent. Do you agree with this?
I wouldn't say the FBI was weaponized. I would say a few people in positions of power were able to direct a single investigation, perhaps for political reasons. Remember, meanwhile, 12,000 FBI agents working 400 different types of violations are still doing their job. But even one time is too much. We can't let that happen. And I think the IG report is a good step in the direction of making sure corrections are made and there's proper oversight in the future.